إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاجزه اللهم خير ما جزيت نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن دعوته ورسالته. ثم أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless each one of you. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that gathered us in this mosque to gather us under His shade in a day that there is no shade but His shade subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ. My dear brothers and sisters, the subject of today's khutbah is basic yet it's fundamental. The subject of today's khutbah is simple yet complex. The subject of today's khutbah is well known yet poorly understood. The subject of today's khutbah is La ilaha illallah. There is no God but Allah. La ilaha, kufrun thumma iman. La ilaha, you disbelieve in every God. Ilahun in the Arabic language is translated to whatever is worthy of worship, to being worshipped. So you are disbelieving in whatever that is worthy of being worshipped except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من كان آخر كلامه من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. لا إله إلا الله, so whoever that is saying La ilaha illallah is his last words, shall enter into paradise, insha'Allah ta'ala. La ilaha illallah is the words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the heavens and the earth for. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَلَا أُرِيدُ أَيْ يُطْعِمُونَ. That I have only created the jinn and the ins for one reason, which is to worship me alone. I do not want any rizq from them, and I don't want them to feed me. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sustainer, ذُو الْقُوَّةِ, that has all the power, al-mateen, the strong, subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illallah is the words that had changed the face of this earth since the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But not only the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Prophet that Allah Ta'ala had sent with those words. You see, the Prophet Nuh, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala has sent him with those words, La ilaha illallah. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ أَنْ أَنْذَرْ قَوْمَكَ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. That there is no God but me alone, and worship me. The same thing with all the prophets, with Prophet Hud, وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ, and to Ad, their brotherhood, وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره. And to Ad, their brother Hud, he said, O my brothers, worship Allah alone, ma lakum min ilahin ghayru, you have no God but Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, la ilaha illa Allah. And the same with Prophet Shu'ayb. Wa ila madyana akhahum Shu'aybun qala ya qawmi a'budu Allah ma lakum min ilahin ghayru. And to Madian, to the people of Madian, their brother Shu'ayb, he said, a'budu Allah, worship Allah alone, ma lakum min ilahin ghayru. And the same with Moses, radiallahu alayhi salam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاعْبُدْنِي وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي, that there is no God except for me, so worship me alone, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ, and set up prayers for my remembrance. To the Prophet Moses alayhi salam. La ilaha illallah is the word of every prophet. Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Ma qulta lahum illa ma amartani bih an a'budu Allah rabbi wa rabbukum. That I've only told people to worship you, my Lord and their Lord alayhi salam. All the prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have came with this message. It's the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, la ilaha illallah, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was humiliated by Meccans and was about to be killed by them for the sake of this word, la ilaha illallah, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected him and took him away from Mecca to Medina. It's the same words that Mus'ab ibn Umayr left everything, and he was known to be the most handsome guy of Mecca, Mus'ab ibn Umayr. He left all that for the sake of this word, La ilaha illallah. It's those words that Umar ibn al-Khattab, they used to say that, Wallahi la yu'minu Umar, hatta yu'minu Humar al-Khattab, that way Allah, Umar should not become a mu'min or a believer until the donkey of his father becomes a Muslim first. And this is what changed the heart, La ilaha illallah, alone, Allahu wahda. This is the word that Ali ibn Abi Talib went from Mecca to Medina, walking on his feet for its sake. La ilaha illallah, he went walking on his feet for those words alone. La ilaha illallah. Those are the words that by the help and the might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had helped after 80 years after Hijrah, the Islamic Empire extended from Spain to India in only 50 or 60 or 70 years by only people who truly believed in this word, truly believed in it and understood it. So where is the problem? Where is the complexity that I'm talking about this khutbah? The problem is with people not tasting the sweetness of this word. Not tasting, not living for this word. You ask many of the Muslims, of the brothers and sisters, what do you understand about La ilaha illallah? And they would tell you that there is only God that we worship in the mosque is the true God. It's not the God that is in the church. It's not the God that is in the temple. It's not the God that is anywhere else. It's only Allah that we pray to. But actually, it's more complex than that, my dear brothers and sisters. The matter is really more complex than that God that you pray to. And the way that I would like every and each one to understand the word God is what is the absolute authority over the one's life. What is the reason that you're coming to the masjid or doing everything? Every word and every action that you take or commit, La ilaha illallah, is it under the authority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The absolute authority over your life is Allah. Is that the definition of La ilaha illallah that you understand? So let me give you a few examples to prove my point. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, أصبح من عبادي mu'minan bi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَصْبَحَ مِنْ عِبَادِي مُؤْمِنًا بِي وَكَافِرٍ. And that was in a time that the sky rained in Hudaybiyah, authentic hadith. أَصْبَحَ مِنْ عِبَادِي مُؤْمِنًا بِي وَكَافِرٍ. That this morning has came in my servants, some of them are believers and some of them are kafir. My servants, عِبَادِي, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about his servants. So that those who said that we were reigned by the power and by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are the believers. And that those who said that we were reigned by the power of the moon, because the moon moved to this side or that side, بِنَوْءِ كَذَا وَكَذَا فَهُوَ كَافِرٌ بِي مُؤْمِنٌ بِالْكَوَاكِبِ. It's the absolute authority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That those who believe that the rain is coming from Allah, even the rain, the smallest thing. And this is the tiniest example that I'm going to be giving today. And the same thing with every aspect or thing that happens to your life. Is it by La ilaha illallah? Are you getting this job that you got by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or because of your connections? Or because of your studying and your degrees that you have? قُلْ إِنَّ الْأَمْرَ كُلُّهُ لِلَّهِ. That all the matters is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. My brothers and sisters, by Allah, if we do understand the meaning of La ilaha illallah, it's completely going to change your life. By Allah, it's going to change your life completely, 180 degrees. And if we as an ummah understand the true meaning of La ilaha illallah, the Islam is going to be like before. Like the izzah that we had before, because we truly believed and understood the meaning of La ilaha illallah. Another example is the Quran saying, اتخذوا أحبارهم وأربابهم اتخذوا رهبانهم وأحبارهم أربابا من دون الله والمسيح ابن مريم. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking in the Quran about the Christians taking their scholars and rabbis as gods other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one of the Sahaba, Hatim al-Ta'i, he was Christians and then he converted to Islam. He told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Wallahi ma abadnahum, that we did not really worship any of them. Why is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying this? And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, أَلَمْ يُحَلِّلُ لَكُمْ مَا حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ فَحَلَّلْتُمُوهُ أَوَلَمْ يُحَرِّمُوا عَلَيْكُمْ مَا أَحَلَّ اللَّهِ فَحَرَّمْتُمُوهُ. That didn't they tell you that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden is halal for you, and you listen to them? And didn't they tell you that whatever that is halal for you, permissible to you, is haram, and you listen to them? فَهَذِهِ عِبَادَتَكُمْ لَكُمْ. And my brothers and sisters, we find many of the Muslims nowadays that are looking for a fatwa from a certain person. And then if this sheikh says something, he goes to another one. Oh, this one I know. He says that the riba is not riba, or the music is haram or halal. I know. I'm going to take the fatwa from that one. And we are doing the same mistakes that the Christians has done. اتخذوا أربابهم ورهبانهم اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله والمسيح ابن مريم. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا. The very next ayah, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا. And they were only commanded to worship one God alone. So is it that God subhanahu wa ta'ala is the absolute authority that is upon your life every day, in every moment? Another example, my brothers and sisters, is in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَلَمْ أَعْهَدْ إِلَيْكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدَمَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا الشَّيْطَانِ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. Surah Yasin. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling everyone, haven't I warned you from worshipping the devil? إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ, he's truly an enemy for you. أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا الشَّيْطَانَ إِنَّهُ كَانَ لَكُمْ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. And in another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, لَعَنَهُ اللَّهُ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has cursed him. وقال لا اتخذن من عبادك نصيبا موفورا مفروضا وقال لا اتخذن من عبادك نصيبا مفروضا that I'm going to take from your servant and slaves نصيب a part that are going to be following me. My dear brothers and sisters, worship Allah alone. لا إله إلا هو سبحانه هو العزيز الحكيم. Another example to prove the point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the absolute authority that should be over the one is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying أَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَاهُ أَفَأَنْتَ تَكُونَ عَلَيْهِ وَكِيلًا. Did you see that the one that is taking his God as his hawa, as his desire, as what he wishes every day? أَفَأَنْتَ تَكُونَ عَلَيْهِ وَكِيلًا. And Ali ibn Abi Talib said, إِنَّمَا أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ إِتِّبَاعَ الْهَوَى. That the thing that I'm afraid upon you the most is following the hawa, following the desire. والحسن البصري said, الجهاد هو جهاد الهوى. That the true jihad for everyone or every believer is the jihad of the hawa. Was to declare war on your desires, on your hawa. And Ibn Taymiyyah said that there is no jihad for anyone until he performs jihad upon his hawa first. So do whatever you want, but you're not going to be able to go for jihad unless you conquer yourself first. And from this, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ta'isa 'abdu dirham, ta'isa 'abdu dinar. That those people that only care about money, you ask them, living all their life just for one thing, just collecting money. And they give nothing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ta'isa 'abdu dirham, that he is truly sad and in disastrous condition, 'abdu dirham, the slave of the dirham and dinar. It's like the dollar and the franc at that time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ta'isa 'abdu al-qatifa, that he's sad, the servant of the qatifa, of the piece of cloth, that he's spending all his life to get it. Khaba wa khasir, he's truly in a loss. And this is, my brothers and sisters, how to help with that is to give your money as charity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like in a masjid like this, I know we need donations for this masjid. May Allah help you and bless your money, inshaAllah, if you would donate to us, inshaAllah. Another example, اتباعُ الشهوات. زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ. And that's a big problem for the brothers especially. You would be walking in the street, and here is the biggest test. You would know what is controlling you, truly. Is it Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or is it the hawa? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, because it's called the words of sincerity. Why is it called the words of sincerity? Because it's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who knows if you're sincere or not. So one of the brothers, Muslims, believers in Allah, saying La ilaha illallah and probably believing in it, will be walking with his wife, and there is a lady coming, or a girl that is undressed, and he would be walking with his wife. Oh, look at that dog. And she would be looking at the dog, and he would be looking at the other side. Oh, so who has the absolute authority over this one, over this person? It's his hawa, his nafs. I have one of my friends telling me that he can do anything for the sake of Allah, but he cannot resist looking at women in the street. He told me it's that bad that even if the Queen of England is walking by him, he cannot resist it. I told him, brother, you really need to go see a doctor. Your problem is not with us. So ذَلِكَ اتِّبَاعُ الْهَوَى. So this is what would tell you if you really believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is, my brothers and sisters, is the complete liberation from anything, from any desire. No one can control you except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. My dear brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. البر لا يبلى والذنب لا ينسى والديان لا يموت لا ينام افعل ما شئت كما تدين تدان. That is truly, the sin is not forgettable. الذنب لا ينسى والديان, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not sleeping. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. And there is a day that shall come in the life of every person that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be talking to him with no translator. ليس منكم, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the authentic hadith, متفق عليه, ليس منكم إلا ومن سيكلمه الله ليس بينه وبينه ترجمان. That it's none of you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not talk to him in person. There is no translator between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he at that time would look to his right and to his left, and that he would only see what he has done in this life. فَيَنْظُرَ أَيْمَنَ مِنْهُ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمَ وَيَنْظُرَ أَشْأَمَ مِنْهُ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمَ وَيَنْظُرَ أَمَامَهُ فَلَيْسَ أَمَامَهُ إِلَّا النَّارِ. And then he would be looking in front of him, and then he would see nothing but the hellfire. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْهَا. So my brothers and sisters, it's the invitation that every and each one of us would be sitting by himself, reviewing how he truly believed in لا إله إلا الله. Because as we have said, that لا إله إلا الله, if it's your last words, truly believing in it, مُؤْمِنًا بِهَا قَلْبَكَ دَخَلْتَ الْجَنَّةَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي ذَلِكَ. And so now one would ask, or one would question, how would someone have his لا إله إلا الله as his last word? And the question for this is easy. مَنْ عَاشَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مَاتَ عَلَيْهِ. That if you're truly living for something, believing in it really hard, you shall definitely die on it, and it shall not be easy. And this is why it's called the word of sincerity. كَلِمَةُ الْإِخْلَاصِ. That you say it and no one would even recognize that you're talking. And try to saying it, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, you will not even find your mouth articulating. So that even if you're in a crowd and saying لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, nobody would ever notice. And there is a hadith in Sahih Bukhari, and this is a beautiful hadith. And if you're only taking this hadith from this khutbah, this is enough for me. Sahih al-Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that whoever says مَنْ قَالَ فِي يَوْمِهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, and try to memorize this, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. That there is no God worthy of worship except for Allah alone, وَحْدَهُ alone, لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ, he has no partners. لَهُ الْمُلْكُ, the dominion is his, وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ, and the praise is his, 100 times. He would get 5 rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 5 beautiful rewards that you should be doing daily basis, very important. First one is that as if he has set free 10 slaves. And imagine the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in setting free only one slave. How about 10 slaves every day? Just saying, just relaxing, going to your work in your car, say it 100 times. La ilaha illallah wahda. لا شريك له له الحمد له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. The second reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that he is giving 100 hasanat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 100 daily bonuses from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just for saying some words. Not listening to music, but says what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this universe for. لا إله إلا الله. The third reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that 100 sayyi'at will be deleted from him, from what he had done ever. 100 hasanat. And the fourth one is the one that I like the most, is that the shaitan will not come close to him. جُنِّبَ نُحْيَ عَنْهُ الشَّيْطَانَ فِي يَوْمِهِ هَذَا. And what a big blessing is that the shaitan cannot come close to you. And you are free from half of what is telling you to do the haram that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like and please. My dear brothers and sisters, if you would move forward, so we can make room for our brothers. And so we have said the fourth reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the shaitan will not come close to him in his day until his night. So you will spend the whole day free from the shaitan. And try it, and it really works. I have tried it myself many times. And you would really feel that you're free. Nothing is telling you to do haram as much. You know? What is telling you to do haram as much is coming from yourself. من النفس والهوى. But the shaitan would be set away from you in that night until your night comes. And the fifth and last thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall be giving you if you're saying this 100 times a day, is that you are doing better than any Muslim on the face of this planet, except for someone that has done more than you. So five things again, we would say this again. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. And he is capable of doing anything that he wishes. And my dear brothers, again, to summarize what we have talked about in this khutbah, لا إله إلا الله has a broader or a more meaning to it than that there is no worship God to be worshipped. It is the absolute authority or what moves you from moment to moment and from day to day. The Prophet ﷺ said, لا تضرني إلى نفسي طرفة عين أو أقل من ذلك. Do not let me to myself one moment or less. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت إنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يعز من عاديت ولا يذل من واليت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت فلك الحمد على ما قضيت ولك الشكر على ما أنعمت به وأوليت اللهم اجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا لا إله لا إله إلا الله اللهم اجعلنا نحيا على لا إله إلا الله اللهم اجعلنا نموت على لا إله إلا الله اللهم تقبلها منا يا أرحم الراحمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا ظالمين وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.